Hi Lovazelle, and welcome back to my channel, and thank you so much for being here. Today we're going to do a little bit of a would I buy it. So I've got some things I bought myself. I also have some stuff from PR. It's all brand new launches, and so I want to give you my opinion if I would purchase them. So before we get started, hit the subscribe button, share this video so somebody think might like it, and let's do it. Alright everyone, so I have some amazing new launches to share with you. All of these products I have actually been trying over the past several weeks, so I am fully invested and have a great feedback and have great feedback for you. Alright, so let's start with this one. This one you know I love. It's Kinship's SPF. It's called their Self-Reflect SPF, but they actually came out with a huge size. So this is much bigger than the current size, and I'm so happy they did this because this is something I use almost every single day. This SPF is fantastic for more of a normal to drier skin type, but the bigger size allows it obviously to last longer, and I'm just so happy they came out with this. So yes, I did get sent this in PR, but I absolutely would buy it again because I've already bought two on my own before this, so of the regular size. So this is the big size. So if you guys want a beautiful hydrating SPF, you don't need to wear a moisturizer underneath it, check it out. It is a physical sunscreen and also reef safe. All right, now this one. This is almost empty, actually. This is the Drunk Elephant Micellular or Micellar Water. I actually use this in my skin clinic. Reason being is obviously they sent it to me. I'm very thankful they did. But it is so gentle on the skin. I can do it right over the eyes of the client. It does remove everything very, very well. Now, would I purchase this myself? Probably not. Bioderma is just as good as this, except for this is more hydrating. This isn't as, I'm not saying that Bioderma is stripping. It just, this is more hydrating and more sensitive to the skin. So if you are a Drunk Elephant fan, this is a good product. But would I purchase it myself? Probably not. But it does have ceramides in it. So it is obviously, like I said, skin nurturing. Now this I actually purchased on my own. This I purchased at Whole Foods. I love cleansers. This was only $18. It was on sale at Whole Foods. This is the Juice Beauty Cleansing Milk. I love a good cleansing milk. I'm actually running out of several of my cleansers, so I needed one for myself. This is beautiful. This does remove makeup. I use this as my first cleanse when I'm not wearing my lashes, or instead of an oil cleanse. You can use this twice. It's more preferred for normal to drier skin types like me. I love to use this post peel, which is where I am right now, because it is so, so gentle on the skin. Nice big bottle, a little bit goes a long way, and it's a beautiful cleanser. So if you are a Juice Beauty fan or at the store and you see this on sale, it is very, very good. I haven't tried a ton of stuff from Juice Beauty, so I'm happy to get this. So I love it. I love it. Okay, so now let's play with a little bit of makeup. Lawless sent me this lip plumper. It is called the Forget the Filler, and it doesn't burn. It doesn't have any kind of those ingredients, but it's supposed to plump the lips. Now, I haven't tried this yet, so we're going to try it together. So they also sent some of their lip liners. I'm actually going to use this lip liner right here. This is in color Pink Sand. They have also some other beautiful colors as well. More of a mauve-ier one. All right, so we're going to do this. This is such a beautiful color. Okay, I'm just going to fill it in a little bit. So this is before, with no lip plumper on. And then here is Forget the Filler. Nice big doe foot applicator. That's really nice. It gets on the doe foot, just so you know. No burning, no nothing. You know, it's like a lip gloss. Pretty color though, right? That's gorgeous. Is there a little tingling? I mean, like a tiny little bit, but nothing crazy. This lip filler is $28. So we're gonna give it some time to do what it's supposed to do, and then we'll do like a side by side and see if we saw any kind of improvements. Yeah, there's like a cooling effect to it, but nothing crazy, like nothing to you know, report home about. But your lips are always going to look a little bit bigger when you have gloss on, because that's just what gloss does to the skin. I'm just looking at the information. It has a proprietary ingredient called Maxi Lip, which is clinically proven to increase volume by 40% and decrease wrinkling by 29%. It works by stimulating collagen production and hyaluronic acid synthesis. It's also pretty. I really think it's gorgeous. So let's see how this goes. I think it's a pretty gloss, but $28, I don't know. I think something else probably would be just as good, but let's just see, give it some time. All right, so this is actually new from Paul's Choice. This is their Skin Perfecting 25% AHA and 2% BHA. This is an exfoliant. They call it an exfoliant peel. It's a rinse-off treatment, and you're supposed to use it once a week. Now, I have used this a couple of times, obviously several weeks ago before I did my peel, but my TCA peel, so I'm talking about. This is a beautiful product. I will tell you, it's extremely effective. It's quite tingly on the skin, but not in an aggressive way. I think Paula's Choice does a really nice job with products like this and their acne products. They do a really nice job. So I really enjoyed this. It's not for somebody that has sensitive skin, though. This is somebody that has congestion, large pores, texture on the skin. That's if you're trying to get that kind of resurfacing result. My only thing is I don't love that it's called a peel, because it's not really. But you leave it on for a little bit, and then you rinse it off. And your skin does feel very, very smooth afterwards, but you can absolutely overuse this. So just make sure if you do end up getting this because you have some of those skin concerns that I just mentioned, don't overuse it. It's a once a week treatment. It should not be used with your prescription Retin-A. It should not be used with any other acid toners. It is a standalone by itself, and then you go in with a hydrating routine after. So this is something that I would do on a Sunday night if that's the type of treatment that I want for that day. Okay, so I like it. Would I purchase it? I probably, if this was my skin concerns, if those were my skin concerns, I might. I actually am looking forward to trying this and see if any of my clients might really use this and benefit from it. Okay, so now these last couple are ones that you guys really, really wanted to know. Let's first talk about this. This is the Biossance Squalene Marine Algae Eye Cream. It's a brand new launch from Biossance. I've been using this for over a month. Little Bit Goes a Long Way. It is a hydrating cream. It is supposed to be lifting and firming the eye area. It can be used on the whole orbital bone, which is nice, and you can get that firming effect. Now, I really have been enjoying this. Again, a little bit goes a long way, so this would last you forever. Obviously, it's Biossance. It has squalene in it, so it's great for hydration, but it also has some kind of interesting clinical studies that they've done. They had after a 28-day clinical study with women between the ages of 35 to 60, they 100% showed improvement in the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles around the eye area. For me, I have been using eye cream for God knows how long. I think it's one of those things that you absolutely should use as a preventative measure, so you can also keep that eye area in great shape so it doesn't age more quickly than it's supposed to. Have I noticed a lifting effect from it? Kind of, actually. I use quite a bit more on my left side because this is the side that usually is kind of more down, and I think it looks quite lifted. I have noticed there is a difference in texture around that eye area, so if you are a Biossance fan, I absolutely would buy this myself. I think it's gorgeous. Now, of course, this does not negate that I love my Derma-E DMAE eye cream. That's also amazing. Different price point, of course, but I loved trying this, and I really, really, really enjoy it. I find myself gravitating towards this a lot, and you need to use it twice a day. So I love it. I think it's great. Now, this one I've also been using for over a month. This is another brand new launch from Biossance. This is the Squalene and Vitamin C Dark Spot Serum. Okay, let's talk about this. So they say it's a first of its kind. It basically says it blends 10% vitamin C and white shiitake mushrooms, and those two ingredients together help to diminish more surface dark spots as well as brightening the overall texture and appearance of the skin. The vitamin C they use in here is a 3-0 ethyl ascorbic acid. So it's a gentler form of vitamin C. So it is going to take a little bit longer to see any lightening results. I think it's gorgeous. It's a serum. So I actually have it on today. It's literally like a lightweight, milky serum. And it goes into the skin really, really quickly. And I've really been enjoying it. Now, I think it's probably gonna be best for people that have more surface hyperpigmentation. So maybe stuff that's post-inflammatory from acne or a bug bite or something like that. I don't think this is like the most appropriate thing to treat like deep melasma, just because there are some clinical other things that we could be doing from a more of a esthetician's point of view, since that's what I am. Now, but I really love the incorporation, obviously, of the squalene or the squalane with the shiitake mushrooms. It is actually proven in some studies that it is a beautiful skin lightener, but their whole approach with this is that it's a gentle way of lifting dark spots on the skin. And the 10% of vitamin C is beautiful. That is one of the sweet spots for most brands over the counter. It is a safe form of vitamin C. It is a generally effective form of vitamin C. And so I think it's gorgeous. Again, if you're a Biossance fan and want something really, really gentle, you can't use any other vitamin C's, that kind of a thing, I think you might want to look into this. It's a beautiful serum and I'm happy to use it. I think it does great things for the skin. But again, I have really deep-seated hyperpigmentation and this is probably going to take a long time to lift that. Also, the one thing that it also has in it is licorice root extract, and that also has been known to help lift dark spots, as well as it's a calming ingredient to the skin. So if you can see here, the trend is calming, but also yet an effective treatment. All right, so the one that everybody has been asking about, this is the brand new serum from Tatcha. It is the dewy serum. Okay, I have used this probably for the past, I'd say, 2 weeks. Now, let's talk about it. The price point's a little high, but they are a luxury skincare brand. It's $88. So for me, it's a touch high. They call this a resurfacing and plumping treatment. Plumping comes from the hyaluronic acid in it, so just keep that in mind. The resurfacing comes from lactic acid. Lactic acid is one of my favorite acids to use for resurfacing the skin. Reason being is because it is so extremely gentle that everybody can use it. You'll see benefits from it, but it is just a beautiful, gentle acid. It can be used nightly if that's something that you'd like to do because that lactic acid is so gentle. They say it's a 3-in-1 serum. It helps to smooth the look of fine lines and texture, obviously with the lactic acid we have just talked about, but that's in their How to Say 3 complex, which is marine algae, rice extract. I'm trying to remember this. How to Say, because it's in all of their products. It's in their essence. Red marine algae, green tea, and rice extract. So that is where that comes from. And then obviously, like I said, it has hyaluronic acid, but it does also have squalane in it, or squalene. It is a vegan form of squalene. It's from olives, and that's gonna be there for hydration. All right, so let's talk about this. I love most things that Tatcha makes. It is a beautiful hydrating serum. You really have to be careful though whenever you're using anything with acids. Make sure you don't use it with your prescription Retin-A, but you can use it with your other retinols. It is extremely deeply hydrating. And of course, the smell is typical Tatcha. It is a natural fragrance, but if you do have a sensitivity to fragrance, obviously this one I wouldn't get. But it is a beautiful, hydrating, resurfacing. It does give a little prickles to the skin, just ever so slightly. So do I like this serum? I do. I think it's beautiful, but I love it because of the luxury factor, to be honest with you. I love how it feels on the skin. It feels plumping and nourishing, and obviously having a little bit of lactic acid in there is not gonna hurt anybody. It's gonna do good things for the skin. $88, I don't know. It's a little touch expensive for me. But again, if you are a Tatcha fan, this is a beautiful way to introduce a little bit of lactic acid into your routine, especially if you are more sensitive to their vitamin C and AHA serum that they already came out with, because it is pretty effective, that serum. So maybe if you have a little bit of sensitivity to that, this might be one to try from the line. Again, I really like Tatcha. Would I personally buy it again? No, because we have so many other lactic acid serums that I really, really love, and they're a lot thinner, but not abrasive. But for me, again, I think it's a good product. I like the formulation coming from an ingredient standpoint. I love the use of lactic acid, but unfortunately, I personally would not buy it for myself just because I have other things that I use. But again, if you are a Tatcha fan, you could absolutely go get a sample, try that out. It is incredibly beautiful on the skin. All right, so if you stay to the end, I didn't announce it in the beginning because I wanted to see who stayed. I am doing two giveaways of two lucky winners for my giveaway. My first one in 2021. I'm very excited. So just comment below, say hi, you know, something. Tell me maybe what product you're looking forward to maybe using out of all of these. That's it. But all you have to do is just be subscribed to my channel, 18 and older, and yeah, I'll get these products out to you. So I will announce the winners. Make sure you always check your comments and see if I've replied to those comments, because that is where you'll find out if you have won. So good luck to those two lucky winners that I'll be announcing very, very soon. You can have all the details are in the description box. Thank you all so, so much for being here, and I'll see you in the next one. Lots of love from me to you. Bye, loves. You guys, I was just about to eat lunch and I forgot I didn't even finish the lip thing. Do they look bigger to you? I'm gonna try to put side by side. I don't know. I think they might look like a smidge bigger. Yeah, I don't know. It's cute. Would I go out and purchase this? Maybe. I don't know. I'll try it for the next few days and I'll update you guys on like Instagram or something like that. Anyway, I totally forgot to even update you on how it's been wearing. I've had it on for like half an hour. I think they look just a little bit bigger, but that's it. All right, you guys, see you soon.